Personalities, parishioners, non-parishioners, friends, and well-wishers. And I want to specially welcome all the members of the Ogunleye family and the relatives of Father Ogunleye. Please, can you stand up? Let's receive. Can you stand up, please? Thank you for coming. Thank you for coming. God bless you. We're happy to have you in our midst. All our elders, all the knights in the house, Knight of St. John International, Knight of St. Mulumba, all the Papa Knights, all the Papa Medalists, you are all recognized. Our immediate past VCs, immediate and other past VCs, you are all recognized. Functionaries of the church, heads of societies, you are all eminent. So we're with our two chief celebrants. And not wasting time, I want to call on Father Austin Okeke to give us the opening prayer.
Almighty Lord and God, we thank you for you have loved us so much. You have filled our lives with your love. You have shed the blood of your Son. You have fed us with the Eucharist. You have strengthened us throughout this day. We have enjoyed all the graces you have showered upon our lives. Receive all thanksgiving in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. You said wherever two or three are gathered, you are in our midst. We are gathered in the name of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. We ask you to bless us with your presence, that the Holy Spirit may take absolute control. You are the God who loves celebration. Your Son Jesus celebrated with those in Cana, in Galilee. We therefore invite him to come and celebrate with us for his sons, that as we rejoice, that our joy will be complete. In the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. We therefore ask him to bless this with his presence in the name of the Father and of the Son, of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Here with us. So we say Emmanuel. Somebody whispered something to me. He said, why are we here? So some people may not know why we are here. So I now welcome the BC to tell us why we are here. Can we appreciate it, please?
3,000 days ago. 3,000. Father Ogunleye came to this parish. So 8 years and 360 days is rough, plus about 20 days I spent before he left. It's 3,000 days. Calculate it, you see. So he has been, he's been here for 3,000 days. It's not a small time in the life of anyone. It's not a small time, and he has become a household name among us. Am I correct? So when somebody like that is leaving, it's only right for us to do what we are doing now. In fact, we were going to do it before he left, But he insisted that he wanted it to be done this way. So Father Willy is being sent off officially today, even though he has resumed in his new location. And Father Peter Moba, that has been with us for how many days? Maybe 20 days or so. So if you compare 20 to 3,000, Father, the journey far. So Father Peter is officially being welcomed while Father Willy is being sent for. And one thing that struck me is when the members of Paraguay's family stood up. It struck me that Paraguay has come on this assignment to work for the Lord. He's been sent even by his family. That is why this group has come to show that Paraguay is our brother, our son. We, as a family, sent him on this location. So it's a clear support, Father, that family is clearly behind you. So we are not going to take too much of time talking. Steve, where are you?
Still here.
Still there. So I believe now we know why we are here.
Yes. You're not here
now. Straight to the point. No time for those jamborees. In our midst, Father, there are some groups that are here to also enjoy with you and spend the night with you. We have the Ikeja Dinari youth organization here. They said you are their chaplain. let's clap for them. Let's appreciate them for coming around. Frank, are you ready? Where street children are rehabilitated. And as we speak, we have about 12 of them who are housed, taken care of, everything you can think of. Lagos State government once in a while will bring in some, after some days take them, but we have residential 12 boys. And I'm sure some of our parishioners don't know this. We've been running this since February officially, but that place actually started in 2018. But the approval from Lagos State government came February this year. So officially since February 2019, that place has been very functional. And you know what it means. When you have 12 heavy young boys in your house, one bag of rice, bah, in 2 days. One bag of garri, in 2 weeks. So, well, we'll come back to you. But I want to bring them to the stage now to let you know what they can do. Can we have you put your hands together for the poster boy?
May God bless you. We want to thank you. And we pray that God should continue to bless you as you lead the church and to the end of the glory spirit.
Very sharp voice. Okay, quickly, we want to take another round of entertainment from this young group. Are they ready? They are not ready? Why are you ready? Then take over the floor. Just relax and enjoy yourself. Let's welcome the choir.
Reverend Father Michael Ogunniyi, SDB. This is our wish for you. We have been together for a while. We have had our joyful times. We have fought. We have settled. And here is our wish for you. Please enjoy. Thank you.
Oh,
this is for you. We pray that we live together. We also pray that when we fight, we settle. Thank you. This is for you.
For them, please, let's appreciate them. We have other presentations, so don't go anywhere. We're going to entertain you down. Tomorrow, I probably got there, but we ain't going nowhere.
What time is mass?
Is it mass? Mass is a normal time, man. Okay, please, I want to change the program a little bit. I want to take two comments from the floor, one from left, one from right, one man, one woman, gender sensitive. Who goes first? 1 minute each. People plenty for back, we're going to entertain us. All right, the immediate past VC, Engineer Charles Ilebunam wants to take the floor. You're welcome, sir. Catholic Church of the Holy Spirit. Don't mind Steve. 1 minute. Can you give one to the boy? Father Oguni, we appreciate you. That's where I want to start. At about that you have been transferred. A lady accosted me in front of the church, said, Father Anenya Yego, this father that normally gives us money, is it true he has been transferred? I said, Madam, you sound like my great-grandmother. Maybe you need to know about that woman. And one day the woman said, this church, I know everything about it. I know about this, your church. I said, what do you know about the church? Is it not? I said, I'll explain. My grandmother said she understood everything about the Catholic Church. That's your church. Is it not the one when you call Nai Deaso, you say, please make aniga for us. You know what's aniga? Locust bean cake. The other time that you use in chasing away hunger. He said, is it not what you pay that woman to make aniga for you? Is that not what you go there to go and do? I know about that, your church. Sorry. I recorded this. Sorry. Just keep it here. It's disturbing. I said, that is not what we go to church to go and do. There are some other things we needed to do. So that lady was sounding like my grandmother. Thinking that Fadoguni's purpose of coming here was to be giving money. I just want to say that because the children will also remember you for giving them sweet. Some other people who come here to come and ask for money will remember you for that. But essentially, I want to call our mind to the fact that we are all here to pick the good things about this faith and make it to heaven. The same purpose for which Father Ogunmiyi came in is the reason why Father Mwamba is also here. So it's a continuation. Those people who say we belong to Apollos and some other people who want to belong to Paul, the scripture asks a very simple question. And what is Apollos? And what is Paul? Is it not that Paul planted the seed and Apollos watered and God had always given the increase? So God will continue to give the increase. Whether Father Mwamba or Father Ogunmiyi, I know that God will continue to give us the increase. So I want us to position ourselves to run with the new parish priest, that the one that went elsewhere will continue until we have a warm embrace of the beatific vision of God on Resurrection Morning. Kali Church of the Holy Spirit.
I said, Republic of Biafra.
Yes, ma'am.
of which I'm the vice president. Father Ogunmiyi, you have spent some time with us, and we've gotten so used to you. So your going away is like taking a part of our body out of us. Personally, I really appreciate you. I have one reason. Let me just emphasize that. Maybe some of you knew that about 2 or 3 months ago, I was very sick. He came to see me, like Father Agbo, like Father KK. But then one early morning, I've not even gotten up from sleep. They told me that Father Ogunmiyi is here. I said, how can he be here this early morning? Then I came out. He said, because he calls Mama. He said, Mama, what kind of sickness is this? You've been sick for so long, and we are missing you in the church. We are missing you in the church. And I felt so touched that he said immediately after morning mass, he said the mass, and he came straight to my house to see me. I mean, is that not touching? Is not that showing love and appreciation for a church member? Father, we are going to miss you. Look, I am going to miss you, and I know the church is going to miss you also. But Father Peter, you have come to us. Like my president has also said, from where he stopped, you will continue. So we are going to appreciate you. We are also going to appreciate you. We are not going to compare you to Father Ogunmiyi, because you are who you are. And Father Ogunmiyi is who he is.
Yo, my boss like this. Come on, this thing fine, no. My wait first. Ah, boss, well done. Well done.
No, I need money.
Oh, we not need money.
My voice is loud now. Young man.
I tell this guy, I leave this thing for years now. I know my boss. Now I don't know. I go tell you, man, see who won't claim this thing. This leg was a dream. Misbehave. Let's go to. Almost 2 days, nobody get his bus. I swear, Nami get out. Hey! Nami get out. I'll buy bus.
Wait.
My bus. Ross, come on here. When I see you, Bangu, I just give man peace. He said, I won't. Ross, don't be my bus. Now my bus. My bus.
Hey, Come on. You see this thing, eh? Forget to Nami get out.
See this one, no. Bangu, I just give man peace.
In the book of Jezebel, that the Bible is all by the two blessings. Now, what more?
My hand is at this Bible.
Officer, drop this man down before I arrest somebody.
Okay, I'm not saying don't show you, and I'm getting this man. Now, our people now get and I make us come here. See, arrest them.
I will arrest you. I will arrest you. When this side. Now, drop this man down.
Shoot them. Shoot them in the
eye. You walk. When this side. I will arrest you.
Drop her now, officer. Say me drop this bag. Drop this bag.
No, 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 no.
Don't be my muscle. Drop.
No, 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 no.
Drop the bag now. Drop the bag. Drop the bag.
One, two,
I will arrest you.
This man.
If once I talk again, I will, you know what that I do. Now, what is inside?
My clothes, not inside.
It's your clothes that is inside. Yeah, she is your clothes.
Why am
I not here? I will arrest you. What is inside?
See, officer, I never smoke anything today, so. So this thing now, now my father, I get time. Forget that for you, and I make me call sicker.
I tell you, yes, smoke him. Now, what is inside?
Officer, I see my life. You know my life.
Calm down. What was that about your life? Why tell me my life? What was
that? Officer, see, my life, no sound the life, Wala. Now my money I keep inside here.
It's your money.
I just say my peace, this was in my bag.
Now what is inside your money?
Now my money is inside.
You won't. Open this thing, what is inside?
Open now.
Open now. Open now.
Open now.
I'm going to arrest your family. I'm going to arrest your generation. What the
fuck? No, finish! Arrest
them! Be my bag.
I will arrest you. I want to go.
Go fast now, officer. They tell us what to do. It isn't about muscle.
Now, my don't. What I like for this one, now I can't see something. Hey, babies, what's up?
Hello, officer, what's up with you?
I'm very good. I need to wait you.
What is it?
My mom, help me read this there. I need you.
I thought you're an officer. You should know how to read.
I will arrest you.
I'm just saying.
I will arrest you.
Sure, excuse me.
Whoa, whoa. Nubes, babies.
Yeah, yeah.
Wajo.
Okay.
Wajo.
Okay. So what do you want to do?
Wajo.
Okay.
Yeah, I read this thing.
Okay. CYUN from Omole saying, farewell, Father Ugunye.
Wajo. What?
Just turn. It's okay now.
Yes, no more bus. Yes, no more bus. Maton, I'm going to arrest you, Maton. Why are you changing now? What was that you? Now, Maton, don't. I will stop you.
And Sion Omole is saying, welcome, Father Peter. Welcome, Father Peter.
Welcome.
Yes.
I'm going to arrest you. My bro, what's up? I don't want.
That is John.
Yes, I'm a...
Oh, you can. Let me help you now.
No.
What about John? John.
John.
Now, let me help you to find this.
Don't worry.
It's fine, sir.
All right,
I'm just coming back from...
Read well, it's full of...
All right.
Why don't I go see my boy tomorrow to take off? I don't mind. My friend, she says this place.
Oh, yes.
Wajo. What's up? Wajo. What's wrong? Take care of yourself. My friend, what's wrong?
I don't know. They tell me here.
What's wrong? I
don't know.
I will slap you. What's wrong? Now you want to know what's the way this place? What do I do with this? What's our voice? I want to slap you.
Baby, how you doing?
Oh, I'm fine.
I'm fine.
How are you?
No, like
no, it's not like that. I can't.
What you cannot? Okay, I understand you.
I want to slap you.
Walk.
put your hand. Okay, put your hand. Oh, Alipe. Put your hand. Put your hand. Put your hand. Put your hand. It's only God that can save us now. Put your hand. Put your hand here.
Put your hand.
Put your hand. Put your hand. Only God I can save us now. Shall we pray?
What on yes fair and what enter their faithful? What you say their power
is on you win.
My son.
Oh, you are still here.
My son.
Can you pray?
Yes. Shall we pray?
Yes, sir. I can pray, sir.
Pray.
What is that
praying
for?
I'm going to pray.
All right, sir, we'll pray. But you know what? You need to have faith in God.
We think of sign faith inside here now.
Believe in God. Eh? God does not belong to you. Leave this. This does not belong to you.
I not touch.
Musa, you have stuff. You better concentrate on your stuff. That's what I have to tell you. God bless you.
Out of the box. Ladies and you are going next. After that, we'll take
which
guy like this guy? These people don't wake up, make them leave. I've gone the look and I saw it since.
And for the love for all women in the church. Whenever we were there to hold our meeting, you will come to give us spiritual guidance and also you will bless us. So, Father, thank you very much. You are well appreciated. And on behalf of my family, I want to appreciate you. I've never become the president of CWO. When you came, you went all the way to the Solo, Metropolitan Senior College, the Solo, to do a farewell Thanksgiving for me there. Even before my family got there, you were there. Father Oguni is very, very time conscious. Whenever he wants to do something, you see him there even before the time. So kudos to you, Father Oguni, for always being there for us. When I was very ill last year, you were always in my house to pray with me. Father Oguni is very, very caring. Yes, every morning, immediately after mass, because I mean weekly masses. Father Oguni will stand there and will say hello, good morning to all parishioners. Even if you are not around for a long time, he will notice and say, I've not been seeing you. Where have you been? That person will not say, I've traveled. That is why you have not been seeing me. So, thank you, Father, for your care and love for all women in the church. Also, there is no way you will deal with Reverend Fathers who will not step on toes. Because when it comes to financial aspect of it, Father will say, no, you can't do that. No, you don't go to that aspect. But when we resolve again, we say, okay, you can go ahead, I can listen with you. Anyway, whenever I go there, I want to sign chair, say, this is a fire brigade approach. No, I can't tell you, we have to leave the Father, no, I'm going somewhere, please. This is very urgent. And he will still listen with me. Father is very flexible. Is approachable. Thank you, Father. We appreciate you. We love you. And we miss you. Our Father, Peter Moba, I'm seizing this opportunity to welcome you to our parish. Although you have been here for some time, and we are enjoying you because it's like you have already stepped into the toes of Father Ogunleye. Thank you very much. And we, all the support you need, we are going to give you. I mean the women in the church. Thank you. To Mary, our mother.
To the Americans, it was a crisis. And to the Catholic Church of the Holy Spirit, it was a blessing. September 11, Father Oguni walked in with Father Carrie Kunel. I was the VC by then. Father, I know, I've said it before and I'll say it again, the parishioners of Catholic Church of the Holy Spirit do not tell lies. And we are not afraid of anybody. So whatever testimony you hear today is coming from the heart of the people, and they actually mean what they say. If you offended us, we'll tell you. Even though there is this, is it an adage or something? They say that the only good priest is the one that has left. That's the one that is not there yet. And you have joined the league of good priests. But we know you are good. You have been good to the parish. You have been good to the parishioners. You have been good to families. Everybody here has one testimony or the other to tell. But we are not going to say anything negative. We can only gossip that behind you.
It's a leader here.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Catholic Church of the Holy Spirit. For those who have not had the opportunity of establishing a parish or seen a parish from the formation stage up to the level we are at the moment, you wouldn't know the enormous work involved. The Salesians that came in, Father Oguni happens to be one of them. They were here when we got the parish. They nurtured the parish from the beginning up to this moment we are. The achievement you can see is what is around you, the infrastructure. But that is not the essence. They are necessary for our worship. They are necessary for us as a parish. But the real work, which is the work of God, which is the essence of the church, may not be very visible or obvious to so many people. And this is the level at which Father Oguni got involved. For those of you who were dear friends or who are still dear friends, you know that at a stage, there was what we call conscription, isn't it? Whether you are up to age or not, you are being conscripted to go to the war front. If there is a master of conscription, it's Father Oguni. He will conscript you. He started with catechism. Now you can settle and join a particular society or any particular group with ease. But we remember that in those days, it was conscription. Father, mother, I mean, go and write your name and all the rest of them. And he nurtured it. It's not an easy thing. I must tell you, because I was part of it. Today, you can wait in the church without any problem. It went through a process of registration and all the rest of them. So we are not going to count the achievement. But the parish has gone through the real process of an organization, whether it is a social organization or a political organization or something. Gwenga Debuja, I hope you are here. These are management experts. They say an organization or a group or a team will first of all go through the formation stage, which we have undergone, true or false. After the formation stage, what is the next stage? Where are the managers? After the formation stage, they will go through the storming stage. After storming stage, what is the next? Norming stage. And then before they go into performance stage. I will say our parish is already in the performance stage. It wasn't easy during the formation stage. It wasn't easy during the norming or storming stage. There used to be crisis. There used to be crisis that nearly tore this particular church apart, whether you know it or not. CCM, CWO, and so many other societies. You know their story very well, true or false. But somebody has already come that stage. And today, you will come into a society, there is no problem. Praise the Lord. Like I said, we are not recounting achievements. But it's good also for us to remember where we are coming from before we get to the stage we are today. Father Oguni touched the parish, he touched individuals, and he touched families, including my own family. I don't want to tell the story because of time. Everybody has his story to tell. But 2015 was a horror for me. I was blessed immensely, and the blessing nearly overwhelmed me. Before I was told by the still voice to meet Father Oguni, and the rest was history. Praise the Lord. There are people with similar testimonies. I know there will be people who will be urging to say something or the other, and there may not be time for it. Father, we are discussing as if you are going to Sierra Leone, where your colleagues go to do, what do they call it? Exercise. But Father is just behind us here. So coming back to Omole is not a problem. The parish house, I know Father Peter very well, is also welcoming. And even if the parish house does not accommodate you, you have homes, you have families around that can accommodate you. So Omole is your place. You're already welcome. There is time for everything. When we are sending Father Daniel forth, I made a statement that there will always be an unfinished business. There is no way you can finish everything that we are supposed to do in a particular place before you leave. Good thing you are missionaries. We don't know whether it's 1 year, we don't know whether it's 2 years or 3 years, but your 8 years here was a blessing to Omole. Praise the Lord. We know also that you are going to be an ambassador of the Catholic Church of the Holy Spirit to the place they have sent you. And they know that you pass through this place, and this place passed through you. There is people who knew Father Oguni when he came in. We know very well that there is a tremendous transformation. True or false? In all aspects of his life. True or false? Praise the Lord. Father, Omole passed through you. You passed through Omole. We praise God for that. We can say so many things, and most of them you will hear are going to be good ones. But let me leave it for so many other people who will also say something after me. We only pray that Almighty God will see you through in the calling He has already given you in Jesus' name. Amen. And therefore, Father Peter, we are here in Omole. I have some people who said you have already stepped into the shoes of Father Oguni. Father Oguni's shoes are different. and your own shoes are different. I know you have already started sharing sweet. That may not be your calling. But because it has to do with children, I'm sure that is why you continued it. I know you will find your own level with time. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
But like I said before, the Catholic Church of the Holy Spirit is in the performing stage. And there is a reason for God Almighty to name this church Catholic Church of the Holy Spirit. Catholic Church of the Holy Spirit. We want this place, Father Peter, to be a solution ground. Praise the Lord. We want this place to be a place where people will say, we are going to Omole to encounter God. Praise the Lord. We want this place to be a place that people will reckon with. The evildoers, when they remember that when they step into the front of Catholic Church of the Holy Spirit, they will be chastised by the Holy Spirit, they will come back. This is the Catholic Church of the Holy Spirit. And this is the performing stage we are. We are not talking of drinking tea, or we are not talking of eating rice or any other thing or something like that. But let me tell you, Father, we are past that stage. We can afford by the grace of God. But we have passed that stage. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
What is our mission as Christians? What is our calling as Christians? If we eat rice and drink tea, and at the end of the day, St. Peter, your namesake, tell somebody, not me, that we never knew you. What a shame. The transformation we want in this church is for us to answer our name, Catholic Church of the Holy Spirit. Catholic Church of the Holy Spirit. Father Oguniyi, I won't say farewell because you are still with us. The place is so close. Father Peter, you are welcome. Praise the Lord.
Twice he called me. Come. You have to serve. I was still running. When he caught me again, he said, look, you just have to serve. I want you to start in the harvest committee. You see, one important thing is he has a way of bringing people in. He has a way of studying every parishioner and understanding them. And another thing is his bundle of energy. He's so energetic. He's so strong. He alone can administer communion without to the whole church. And he's a very good family man. He knows everybody. He knows the members of the family. And he will reach out to everybody. And another very important thing is, he's so humble that he listens to everybody, to the high, to the low. He has a listening ear. The other important part that I must mention is the difficulty getting him to come to this occasion. It was so difficult. Because I saw his point. He didn't see any reason why he should be rewarded. But I had to be talking to him, I had to convince him that it's not reward. Give people opportunity to acknowledge you. You know, it took quite some time before eventually he agreed. So on this note, I must really appreciate him. I must pray that the good Lord will continue to strengthen him. The good Lord will continue to uplift him and move him to the final desired destination, which is the ultimate for everybody. As for our incoming Father Peter Mbobla, he has his own style. And certainly, he's stepping into the shoes of Father Wuni. But said he has his own way, he wants to do his thing. And we really appreciate him because we have to be so happy about the way God has ordered events in this church. Father Wuni did a lot of work, building, putting families in their position. And then, all of a sudden, Father Peter came in and gave us a small snap of what is going to happen in this church the first Friday. I was telling him that I was shocked. I was discussing it with people. I said, God is great. We thank God for the things that are happening in this church. Catholic Church of the Holy Spirit.
We don't always agree. That is basic. Today, I've heard a lot of things, good things about Father Oguniyi. Nobody has shared any challenge. Nobody has said any challenge. I learned today Father shares tea and all that. But was that the marketplace gossip in the church? A lot of parishioners say Father Oguniyi is stingy. A lot of parishioners. So today I'm surprised to hear everybody saying he gives me tea, he gives me that, he gives me that.
Not everybody, they're tired.
Beware of the tongue of flatterers. And that's what I want to tell the incoming parish priest. The present parish priest, Father Peter. Beware of the tongue of flatterers. Father Oguniyi has worked tirelessly. I commend him for having a large heart, particularly when we were pursuing the documents of this church. A lot of rubbish was spread in the parish, but he handled things very maturely and worked diligently. Anywhere we needed to go, Father was always there. I can say that for him. And one striking thing about Father Oguniyi is that he knows his parishioners. If he tells you this about this person, he'll be vindicated. And the empowerment committee, we're about to give out loan facilities to parishioners. There are some fathers who say don't give. But we go ahead to give. And at the end of the day, those who have not paid any cover. So his ability to know his parishioners is one thing that is very striking. But he has his own challenges. Father wants to be all things to all men. It does not always work out. Because when you please everybody, at the end of the day, you may please nobody. That is the only challenge I have with Father. You cannot always please everybody. I will talk to Father Peter. Everybody, many people will come and say, oh, you are doing well, you are doing well, you are doing well. Some of us will always speak our mind. Areas that we believe are areas of challenges. And that's what I will also Father Oguniyi for. He knows me very well. There are many areas I will point out to him. This is not right. We discuss. Some he takes, others it's his prerogative as parish priest to accept whatever advice. It's not compulsory. He must accept an advice. He takes it, some he discards, and we move on. But beware of people, parishioners, who will always tell you that everything is okay. Everything can never be okay. And nobody is perfect. So as we grow as a church, have that large heart to also accommodate people who will tell you that this is not out of malice. Because people tend to believe that when you raise issues, you don't like them or you are criticizing them. They label you all sorts of names. Some of us have gone beyond that level. We don't really care about it. All that concerns us is that we are working in good conscience. Father Oguniyi worked in good conscience. He did it his own way. Father Peter, you have your own way. and you will chart your own course the way you want the parish to go. Father Karikule came before both of you and he had his own way. I don't believe in comparing anybody. Because soon they talk of programs in the church. I don't care about that. Everybody has different level of faith. So just do it your own way. Be focused on what you want to do. And at the end, God will bless each and every one of us in Jesus' name.
Amen. Parish priest I was close to. I was not a Catholic when I got married, but I got married in the village in Auchi. So the Catholic church there, if you know village church, immediately after the mass, you always see people, they greet each other. You know yourself. Everybody, you just know yourself. It's a small community. When I came to Lagos, I went to St. Cyprian. We stayed there for about 7-8 years. I would just come and go. Come and go. Morning, afternoon, I come and go to church. I don't know anybody. Nobody knows me. I went to St. Leo. The same thing. Come and go. Come and go. But when I came to Omole, I was coming. But Father Guni, in short, it's like it's all in the SDB's fathers. They always like greeting. Because even Father Karukune, when he was as quiet as he is, he always greets in his own little way. I started my coming and going, but I didn't do it for too long when Father Ogunui noticed me. I said, God, he keep calling me, ah, madam, you must serve, or you must do this, things group, or this, so always calling me at school, because then my school was very far. I would tell him, Father, my school is too far. My school is at Munshi. It's just too far. I can't do anything. I told him, he said, okay, we met one, two parishioners to see what we can do to get transferred close to this place. But unfortunately, it didn't work. God had to take his glory. I got my transfer here. And I said, ah, you have no excuse now. You must serve. So he gave me opportunity to serve, and I really enjoyed it. And in the serving, he also taught me how to relate with people, because I am somebody that always come and go. Once I reach anywhere, I always want to sit in the corner. So yes, I want to tell him thank you. He has really made me to be a monk. I've been married for going to 25 years. Is this church I joined CWO? Is this church I joined CCM? In my former parishes, come and go. And I also want to thank him for his leadership style. I have learned that to always deal with my students. Father don't have protocol. Wherever you meet him, you discuss, he gives you answer. You don't call him, Father, I'm coming. Once he's around. For now, that is how I treat my students. I can even mark their notes on my way. I don't say, go and do anything. I've really learned that from you. And it's really making my work moving on. I don't have too much workload again. So, Father, I say thank you for the opportunity to teach me to love Catholic Church.
You came or you did not come. I remember, I think it was within the first year that Father Guni was here, came in. I was outside this country, and one day my phone rang. And when my phone rang, when I looked at it, a Nigerian number. Okay, I picked it, and it was Father Guni. He said, I haven't seen you in church for about 2 weeks, so something like that, so I'm calling. So I said, oh, Father Guni, I'm not in Nigeria. Yeah, I wondered, oh. Ah, so far I noticed that I didn't come to church. And I know that just as he noticed for me then, that is how he notices for every other person who don't come to church. And since then, although he doesn't phone again, but you know, when I come, when I appear sometime, he says, is it traveler? Oh, I forgot you. He said, okay. he would say so, and I would just laugh, you know. So, that little touch is a personal touch, and I think it affects everyone. Everyone gets to feel it. The fact that, Father takes out time to to touch you, to look upon you, to know what's happening to you. Make the mistake of inviting Father Oguni to a party or maybe birthday or something. Maybe you'll be thinking that he won't come. You are wasting your time. Father Oguni will come. Father Oguni will come. And you know, there are very few Reverend Fathers who actually attend events and actually mixes with you. And unless you are told that he's a Reverend Father, maybe you'll be watching that he wouldn't take some drinks that you offer. Maybe you will, if you are watching him. But you know, he mixes very well. Mixes very well, and I think that endears him to people and parishioners. Nigerians are petition writers. I don't know whether there's anybody who wrote petition against Father Oguni. So, I think that's a big plus. Because Nigerians are petition writers. Petition writers. So if nobody wrote petition against you, then you know that in this church, then you know that you've done well. And you've done well. And I can tell you that from my own perspective, you've done well. One other thing too that I would say, I'll commend you about for. In many churches, they are aging. You find the aging population taking over the church. But in Catholic Church of the Holy Spirit, in fact, I told somebody was saying to me, a colleague was saying to me that, oh, my church, we lack the young people. The young people are not there. So they are wondering what. So I said, young people are not in your church? He said, no. That they are, it's all people are of her age. I said, I'm surprised. And I said, in my church, it's not like that. There are so many young people. And she said, which church is your own? I said, Catholic Church. She said, how can I say? I said, many Catholic churches, only old people who are there. I said, not in my own. There are many young people in my own Catholic church. You know, she was surprised because she's Anglican. And she kind of felt that Anglican would be like Catholic, where the population is aging. And most of the young people have gone to Pentecostal. But I told her that, no, my own church is not like that. But I know that what is making the difference is the style of the Don Bosco. So I'll commend you and I'll commend the Don Bosco order. Because the fact that you are for young people, the fact that you cater to the needs of young people, I think there's a special touch. There is an experience that the young people are getting, which they are perhaps not getting in maybe some other Catholic churches or some other Orthodox churches. But there is something special in the Don Bosco order, which I want to commend the Don Bosco order as a whole, and for Father Oguni in particular. Since you are the arrowhead, you are the arrowhead of it in this church here. I would say that although you're leaving us, you are still not leaving us, because just as one of school have said, we are just at the backyard here. You can always come in at any time. I know it's not the same, but we'll miss you, and I know you will miss us. But change is the constant thing. And we wish you well, and I have no doubt that you will
appreciate Father Oguni. I think so far in the history of this church, he has been a priest that has stayed longer than other priests. I think he has broken the book of record. We are yet to see another priest that will stay as long as he stayed. And then, we also recognize Father Oguni, like others have said, is a workaholic. He works whether we noticed it, I mean everybody noticed it or not. One thing is sure, he likes working. He likes practical. His own faith is not by hoping. His own is faith with action. And so we have learned some things from him. And you know, we all know him As somebody that is very, very principled, is a very principled human being, that if you don't understand his principles, you have problems with him. And that is his type of person. So, and then, on behalf of the charismatics also, maybe that one is a kind of protest. You didn't give us tea. You didn't call us for breakfast. And personally, you don't know my house. Everybody say you know their house. You don't know my house. Maybe, you know, at the tail end of his staying here, even though the date of his departure was approaching, he worked hard enough to accomplish the project he had on ground. Maybe before he leaves tomorrow, he will accomplish my own by calling me for tea and calling Church of the Holy Spirit. Okay, Father is clapping, so there is hope. So I am not going to stand up and talk again, but on behalf of the charismatics, we have a small envelope. And our former VC taught us, and the last one, the letter is for the person it is meant for. So it's not for public consumption. It is addressed to Farugui, and nobody should open it, even me. Thank you so much.
Don't give her. Thank you.